So who did you play? What? No, what team? What team did you play? Rent free. Oh, the. Oh, you mean you want a copy of that match from just now? Where were you playing them? Last night. Okay. So that was it? Okay. Okay, so this is. This is almost 2 gigs. Okay, and then what else do you have?
That one.
Let me mark this one. Okay.
That one can just match everything.
Just now. Okay, so. One and a half gig. Okay, so I have to convert these files. Okay, it takes about half an hour, 20 minutes to do it. So let me convert these files and then put them on a flash drive for you. $15 altogether for both of them, for both the matches. So one, well, I'll give you a flash drive with both of the matches, and it'd just be $15. It's $10 for one match, and then $5 for any additional match, because I basically have to re-encode it to make it big enough for the flash drive.
And then can I get, like, once we do that, am I able to get on my flash drive with your given name and be able to screenshot certain shots that I was doing?
Well, yeah. I mean, do you know how to do a screenshot? Well, it'll look as good as it's gonna look. Yeah, it's video. You know what I mean? It's not a camera, so it's not a photograph. But let me go ahead and. Okay, no problem. You do have another one coming up? Okay, so then maybe what I'll do is I'll hold off on giving you the flash drive, because you're probably gonna want that last match too. So then that's gonna be $20. Okay. And it's only like the money is thing. It all goes to the ACS.
For what? Right now, I don't even know. Only depends on who we're going to play next if I want that.
Uh huh. Yeah. You're probably going to want it.
We'll see. But those two for sure.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm Daniel. Dun 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 dun. All right. Thank you.
All right, let's get back to this match here. So I don't know what the score is. As soon as I see somebody strafe across the floor here, I'll ask them what their score is. But looks like we got Regulators and Money Shot. I think the two, see, I can't tell if these are Regulator players or Money Shot players. So let's just focus on the actual games. So we got the goatee or the beard guy on the back table with the white watch calling the corner pocket. These guys are playing race to 13. And there it is. Flablam. There's also a match going on that table behind it. Anyways, front table here. Shooting at solids. He's got, I think, an easy stop shot on the six ball. And then he's got a little bit of a wall around the eight. So actually, this is not straightforward run out. But it looks like the six ball has a little bit of angle to the side. Well, maybe not that much angle to the side pocket. But if he can get like a straight shot on the rail on the five ball, just stun it back, bam. Uh-oh, he might have frozen up to that stripe. He's taken away his own shot. He's sighing at the pool gods. And yes, even though there's only one God, we only use that as a figure of speech. So, back table. Power break. Cue ball flies off the table. Not flies, rolls. Grounder to third. Little audience participation there from one of the food bar team players. So anyway, this gentleman here, he froze himself to the stripe. So now he's playing a very difficult kick shot. That's gonna be a foul. And Roy's, AKA Money Shot, Roy's bar, straddles up to the table, struts to the table. He's going to take ball in hand. Looks like a pretty straightforward, pretty easy run out. Okay, so looks like the Regulators are getting all riled up over there. They're kicking ass and taking names. Fairly straightforward run out for this gentleman. Should be okay. I like maybe just, you know, draw back on the 10 ball. Use the back, the rail that he's shooting from. Draw back to the rail and bounce out. Get another straight shot on the 13 ball. Oh, he had enough angle to play with it a little. Well, he's slightly on the wrong side of this 13, but he should be okay. Corner pocket called. The Regulators lose that game. Money shot wins. Fist bumps all around. Nice win. Nice win. All right. And now, in the pink hat, the Regulators will break. We're playing eight ball, son. It's a man's game. Come on now. Gotta love these team events. A lot of adrenaline in the air. And once again, we'd also like to thank Red Tree Jewelry for working with the ACS Texas this year. It's been a pleasure to have the Red Tree Jewelry people here with their various wares and crafts. So Christmas is coming up. If you're looking for anything special, we recommend you check out redtreejewelry.com. And I believe they also do custom work, too, so definitely somebody to keep in mind. Support those that support the billiard industry. That's what I say. Okay, so it's money shot. Gonna have to take a seat at this table, and our man in the white watch is back. Yeah, I don't know the score. Hold on. Hey, do you know the game score, guy? Do you know what the game score is? All right, I got my little worker. See him walk across the screen there? Got my little worker going on. 11-9, you. All right, so money shot's got 11. Race to 13, folks. It's getting serious now. This is the part of the match where nobody can sit still. A lot of nerves, a lot of high energy. Tensions are high. Ah. The gentleman with the white watch, his name is Brandon. Brandon Mullen. Hey! Hey!
What's up?
I'm good. Hey, put that on for me so it's comfortable. We have a treat. We have a special treat, folks. It's a very, very special treat. And actually, before I introduce him, I'm going to say it's been a very special treat for me to come to Texas and provide you guys with the coverage here. This has been a blast, And it wouldn't have been possible without the efforts of people that I'm sitting with now. His name is Rand Roberts, and he is the current president of the ACS Texas Association. And I want to thank you personally for inviting POV Pool to come here and provide the coverage of this year's Texas State 8 Ball Championships. Thank you very much. Yeah.
We've enjoyed you being here. Everything seems to be running pretty well.
Well, that's good. That's good. How have you been doing this year around? You've been enjoying it? Has it been more work, less work? What do you think?
Well, as it grows, it's a little more work, but it's okay. It's worth it. Everybody's having fun.
Yeah.
That's all we care about. Good pool, good fun.
Yeah.
Meet new people.
Keep growing. Seems like what you guys do, too, is reach a little higher every year because, you know, for example, you're going to go to Port Arthur next year, aren't you?
We are. We're going to head to South Texas.
Yeah.
And we've got some really great support from that area,
mm-hmm.
and they're going to take good care of us and put in some extra money. We expect to, this year we had $5,000 added, and our tournament next year we expect it to be added up to $10,000.
That is wonderful news, and that's just a testament to the growth of ACS and the American Q Sports organization.
I agree.
And, you know, I personally was overwhelmed by, you know, how many people you guys get from local areas as well as from far-off areas in Texas.
Well, we got, what do we have? 73 teams, 44 mixed, and 28, 29 ladies.
Yeah.
And a large percentage of them are from the San Antonio area.
Mm-hmm.
The next highest percentage is from the Dallas-Fort Worth area.
Mm-hmm.
And the rest are scattered from Austin area,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Temple, Killeen, Belton area, mm-hmm. and Houston, Beaumont, Port Arthur area. And we're happy that they all enjoy this enough to keep traveling to see us once a year.
That's excellent. That's excellent. What would you say, if there was anything I could help you with on this live stream, you know, just getting the word out to people, what would you say there would be, you know, one thing that you would say you need more of, whether it be more vendors, more sponsors, more members, more league operators? What would you like to see over the coming 12 months, maybe 12 months to 3 years?
Well, we'd like more of the people that to dual sanction or that play in some of the other leagues to include our league, so their players can come to our tournament as well as some of the other state and national tournaments.
Okay.
And so that would be what word I'd put out to other league operators.
Mm-hmm.
And other than that, we just like seeing the steady growth that we can handle and keep everybody playing good pool.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And you seem satisfied anyway. You do.
I enjoy it. It's a good thing to be part of.
Yeah. If there's anything I've noticed about Mr. Roberts here, he is extremely low maintenance. Hands-off kind of guy, and I don't think there's been a moment where I haven't turned my head to see him and he's not smiling. You know, that says a lot, yeah. Especially for the tournament environment.
I've got a lot of good help. They take care of things. I'm just here if needed.
Good.
If everything's good. I like it that way.
Yeah. Did you start the ACS Texas or did
oh,
you,
no, no. It,
did you join
here,
on?
Been here for many years before I came, got involved.
It started in what, 2000?
Janet's been involved.
2007, 2008? 2005.
Well, at the ACS, yes. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, it evolved after the BCAPL and ACS split. So
yeah.
Prior to that, we still had similar tournaments and similar activity.
Yeah.
It's all good. Okay, I'm going to move on. Back to the podium and
okay,
try to
Ren.
Keep things working.
Ren's shy.
You're doing a good job, Daniel, and we appreciate it.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
Come back and see us in Port Arthur next year.
I would love to, and hopefully I'll bring my better half, Geraldine, too. You'll love her.
That'd be great. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Ren Roberts, everybody. Short but sweet, and I'm not talking about his looks. So that was Ren Roberts, and I got to tell you, he's just been wonderful to work with and for, and you know, it makes you feel good when he looks at you and he makes you feel like you can do no wrong, you know, and that's huge, you know. So with that, I think Janet Ibarra is going to come and show up in a minute too. Anyway, back to this match. I know there were some games won there, and I'm not sure if it's a Hill 9 or Hill 10 or 11-11. Not sure what it is. Robert Chaney, do you know what the score is? Do you know who's up and who's down? It was 9/11 when Ren Roberts came to the store front. Is it really Hill 9? Wow. Thank you, Pat. It's my Pat, my unofficial scorekeeper. So, money shot is on the hill. Robert Chaney says, I'm sure it's 11-10. Okay, I'll find out as soon as I see somebody win a game. Oh, so it, okay. So it's 11-10? Okay. Come on now, we're doing our best. Wait, 11-10 or Hill 10? Wait a second, I got... This is pretty easy out, actually. Could it be Brandon Mullen to close it? All right. So that puts money shot on the hill. Looks like money shot is close to a run out on that back table as well. So you have this player for the Regulators right here. And I got to tell you, when you're down like this and you got games in progress, this is where you can get into trouble. Because if you take too long to shoot, this means other games are going to get in progress. So I don't recommend stalling games. I mean, I haven't seen him shoot in like 3 minutes in the middle table. Have you? Has anybody seen him shoot? Okay, he shot. But you don't want to take too long to shoot at this point of the game, because you got to get on the board as quickly as possible. You're down two games. You want to make your contribution. I know that 8-ball is a tough game, but you don't want the set to be over just before you're down on the 8. I'm sure that's come up before in some matches where, you know, someone's trying to run out. And I would imagine there's been disputes over all right, so score now is 12-11. Regulators trying to make a comeback. I mean, I know it's not speed pool, you know, but yes, I'd be curious to know if anybody, if that's ever come up where two tables are shooting on the eight ball on opposite teams, hill. How you doing, Brandon? Huh? Sit down. Come on up. Yeah, come on up. Brandon's going to come. He's going to be the money shot poster child. Here we go. Let's go. Put that on so you're comfortable. All right. It's Mullen, right?
Yeah, Mullen.
Brandon Mullen's here. Hey, man, we got a couple of your fans in the chat room. Robert Chaney.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. How you doing? I'm Daniel.
Good. Good, Brandon. Yeah. Nice to meet you.
Playing good.
Thanks. Yeah, I had a couple of good outs with some dumb mistakes as well.
You know, these guys are working hard. They're trying to make a comeback on you.
I know.
It's 12-11, right?
Yeah, we're on the hill.
Yeah.
They need the last two here.
So it looks like... looks like the guys on Money Shot, no, Regulators, just fumbled over there on the middle table. So,
yeah, I didn't get a chance to see it. What happened? Was that on the break?
No, he was on his third solid. So, who's your man over here?
But it was off the break, like Billy.
Yeah, off the break, I think. So now Billy's shooting, and you know, there's three less solids on the table, so that's good.
I didn't know if this was his first time he was at the table.
I believe it was, or maybe Billy broke dry, you know. Trust me, it's not easy tracking three tables at once.
No joke.
You would think it's easy, but it's not. It's not as easy as you think.
Well, heck, man, it's. I feel like the disadvantage of that is you have to watch your players.
And a chat room.
Oh, and a chat room.
Yeah.
Oh.
So, how you feeling, man? You jazzed? Win or lose, you jazzed?
I am. I feel pretty good about the way I played. It was good.
This is a one-loss match, right?
Or
So this is not...
Yeah, I feel pretty good about it. It's besides the cold weather and the sinuses, it's been pretty well.
Yeah. So I guess the match to really watch right now is Billy. Uh-huh. Because Billy is... you guys are on the hill, and Billy's closer to the finish line than this front table
Mr.
here.
Mr. Taylor. Yeah, I don't see much trouble. I mean,
I don't either. I mean, he's got
11.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's that 12 passes a 7 or if he shoots it inside.
Yeah, I think you can safely start figuring out what bills you're going to pay this week.
Well, if I get it, I'm going to go give me a case right over there that I've been wanting.
Oh, well, there you go. See, you're already counting.
I need that double backpack strap kind of thing.
Oh, yeah, like the JB case.
Yeah, that's what. Yeah, I didn't know if I could say the.
Sure, you can say
yeah,
it.
I did not.
Yeah. I like John Barton. Good guy. He's sponsoring POV Pool.
I don't know what he just did there.
Yeah, he did get out of line a little, didn't he?
I mean, is that the 10 that's on the long rail over on our side?
I think it's the 14 down there by the 8 ball there on the rail.
On this side?
That's the 14.
Oh, okay. Oh, I guess the monitor.
It's kind of like mid-range, you know, mid. It's not going to be that hard, but he will have to do something with the cue ball because he might be hooked like 12-10. Yeah, there you go.
Well, I don't think the 8 passed the 4, so he's having to shoot in the other corner. I figured that would be his cue ball that he did shot.
Yeah. Well, here's his other cue ball, too. So.
I meant as far as like the last ball.
Yeah, no, I know the cue. I know what a cue ball is. Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, did I use it wrong? I mean, was he using
well, other key ball meaning, you know, he took out the first key ball. Now he needs another one.
Yeah.
But that
so the 15, he'll just.
15, I guess he'll probably.
Oh. Use it, get an angle, come on, go over long rail, and hopefully.
I like actually using if I can't use a cue ball near the eight, I'll go up table and use a cue ball up there and then use two rails to come around. He likes to come this way.
I watch a lot of pool online and stuff and listen to the commentators.
Oh, do you?
It kind of helps me. Good. You know, I like to listen to them to see what their thoughts are.
But. Yeah. Where in Texas are you from?
Fort Worth.
Okay.
Yeah, we're all we're all Fort Worth area. But
he looks to be a little straight on this 15.
Yeah.
Which
does it pass the four?
I don't think it does, Brandon.
It does either.
I really don't think it does.
Or
maybe it does. Maybe it does.
Holy cow!
I think he's got like 3/4 of a pocket or something.
Wow.
Okay.
Here's for
you wanna go put that case
finals.
On reserve now?
Get to the finals if he
get out of the way. We need to see this.
Oh.
Get out of the way. Yes. He made it. All right, congratulations,
all right,
Brandon.
Hey, that's pretty cool to do this for the first time. Maybe I'll be back on the
all right, ladies and gentlemen. Brandon Muller, he's having fun. Team celebration. Well, congratulations to the Regulators. They will exit stage left with third place, $1,450. And Money Shot will go on to play Los Borrachos in the finals. And it is only 4:30. I like the sound of that. This has been a whole lot of fun. I want to thank you guys for watching today, and keep loving pool. We're not finished. We're going to have something else real quick. Yeah. Money Shot. They got the Money Shot. Oh, wait a minute. Money Shot won it, not the Regulators. Did I say the Regulators? Yeah, Regulators gets third place. I believe that's what I said. Now, on to the finals. Yes, Pat Hickok. On to the finals. Yes, sir, Robert Cheney.
Are we playing the last one here?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He'll probably put you on this side. Find out from the TD. I'm not 100%. Not 100%. Ask a TD. Ask the TD.
Who do you work for?
It's POV Pool.